We are. Hey, kids out there, wherever you are. I'm so glad you tuned in to Grow today. I'm sure you didn't expect to catch me picking my nose. Well, as you can see, I love books. I have a collection of books. Out of all these books, my favorite book is the Bible. Lately, I've been reading about this guy in the Old Testament. I love his story. He has a special kind of intelligence. Like a spy intelligence to resolve different situations. This intelligence is called wisdom. He wasn't born a wise guy that way. He received this super helpful intelligence in a dream. Who gave him this intelligence, this wisdom? Very soon you will find out about this hero of the Bible. But first, stand up, grab somebody in your house, and ask them to join you to worship Jesus. See you soon.
Clap your hands and wave your arms. Play the drums and then rock the guitar. So clap your hands and wave your arms. You can play the drums and then rock the guitar. Clap your hands and wave your arms. Play the drum and then rock the guitar. are small. Nothing is impossible for a super wonderful God. Every day I can know God is always there for me and my family. Every day I can know greater is the one who lives inside me.
Worshiping God is so important, and our Bible hero learned that as a kid, in his home, in a palace. Whoa! His dad was King David, huh? And David was a worshiper of God. He worshiped God with all his might. He wrote songs and he played instruments to worship God. Today's hero was raised to love God and to worship Him. So, let's do a reveal to see who he is. At a young adult age, he was given a very big task. He became king. That's right, king. Oh, yeah. Oh, it seems he would have only been about 20 years old. And God himself chose Solomon to be king, even though he had an older brother. And usually, the older brother would be the next king.
Wow, God revealed his special plan for Solomon's life to his dad, King David. David told Solomon all of the plans that God had for him. And one of them would be to build a gigantic temple for people to gather and to worship God. He also reminded Solomon to obey God, to be a good king. He told Solomon, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or be discouraged.
Yes, my dad shared all these special instructions with me before he died. But my dad loved God with all his heart. He was a great king. I miss him. Now here I am, a king. I have big shoes to fill. I want to be strong and courageous, but instead I feel scared. Will I be a good king over Israel? How will I build a temple? I have so little experience. I'm so young. It's a big responsibility to be a king, to lead a nation, God's people.
Yeah, Solomon felt pretty inadequate with that new role. But the good news is he loved God and obeyed his commandments. Very soon, he would experience something special with God. It happened during a trip he took to go worship God at Gibeon, a city near Jerusalem. There was a very big tent set up there called the Tent of Meeting. Many Israelites would go there to just worship God. It was a temporary place until a beautiful temple would be built.
It took a few days to get there. It was a precious time to worship God, and I honored him with 1,000 burnt offerings. But being far from the palace, I camped that night. I went to bed and fell into a deep sleep. And as I was sleeping, God appeared to me in a dream. It was the best dream ever, a glorious dream. And God said to me,
"What do you want? Ask, and I will give it to you."
Wow! Imagine that! Solomon could ask for whatever he wanted, and God would give it to him. His mind must have been like racing, wondering what he should do. What should that be? If God would ask me that same question, how would I answer? Would I ask for money so I could go on a vacation? Ooh. Or maybe a brand new sports car. Woohoo. What fun that would be driving around. Woohoo. Or would I ask for lots of money so I could buy fancy clothes? Or would I ask to bless others? Like healing sick people that I know. Kids, what would you ask for? Let's see what Solomon asked for in his dream.
Oh Lord, my God, you showed your great and faithful love to my father David, and now you have made me king in his place over Israel, your chosen people. But I don't really know how to lead them. They are so many. I am in such a need of your help. Oh Lord, my God, I know exactly what I want. I want your wisdom in me, a heart that knows between right and wrong, between just and unjust. Give me your wisdom so I can lead your people well.
Solomon, I am very pleased with your request. I will give you what you asked for. Great wisdom I will give you to lead my people. I will give you a wise and understanding heart, such as no one else has ever had or ever will have. You did not ask for riches and fame, but these I will give you as well. In your lifetime, no other king will ever be compared to you. And if you continue to follow me and obey my laws and commands as your father David did, I will also give you a long life.
Solomon woke up from his dream, but you know what? His dream wasn't what we call a pizza dream. This dream was a meaningful one. He had a real conversation with God. Kids, our awesome God speaks to people in different ways. With Solomon, he chose to speak to him in a dream. His dream was one that would change his life.
After the dream, the very first thing Solomon did was to thank God at that special place in Gibeon. He worshiped God by giving more burnt offerings and peace offerings. Then he invited all his palace workers to a big, very big party with lots and lots of food. I love food. And this was all to honor God, to celebrate his goodness over him.
Solomon asked for wisdom. He knew wisdom comes from God only. His focus was to honor God because he loved God. Solomon wanted God's help to be just in his rulings and to be a good king for God's people, the Israelites. He did not ask to be famous or important or rich. He knew he needed God's wisdom above anything else. I think it was pretty wise of Solomon to ask for wisdom.
Where are those glasses? I really need to find them. Oh, phew, here they are. Oh, I found them. Oh, these glasses, they really help me to see. Cause my eyes, they have a little defect, you know? They're nearsighted, which means anything far away looks fuzzy or unclear. But these glasses, oh, they take care of that problem. When I put them on, I can see clearly. No more fuzziness. And I love seeing well. Guess what? God's wisdom can be compared to my glasses. Wisdom helps us to see clearly what a good choice is. No more fuzziness with wisdom. You see very well what is not good for you. Wisdom gives me a clear vision of the good things to say and do. Well, I know very clearly that I want God's wisdom.
God gave great wisdom to Solomon. Shortly after his dream, two ladies came to see him with a big problem that they couldn't resolve on their own. So King Solomon quickly found out that God had answered his request, his desire to be wise, to be full of wisdom. Let's see what happened, how Solomon clearly knew what to do.
I am so thankful to King Solomon. My baby's life was saved because of his great wisdom. Because I had this huge problem. I shared a house with this other woman and we both gave birth to a son within a few days. And one night, the other woman's baby died. She quietly came into my room and took my sleeping baby and then put her dead baby near me. When I woke up to feed my son, I was shocked and I was scared. This was not my baby. She had my baby, but she didn't want to give him back. So we went to King Solomon for him to make the decision. The other mother and I came with our babies and we argued in front of the king. And she told him that my son was hers. And I said, no, the dead baby was hers. Then King Solomon said something that terrified me.
God is so good. Right away, I knew what to do. I knew God had answered my request. His wisdom was in me. I knew both women would be in shock by what I would say, but it would also solve their problem immediately. So I told my servant, get a sword, then cut the living baby into two pieces and give each woman half of the baby. But we were not going to kill the baby, but the moms didn't know that. It was a setup to reveal the true mother, and it worked.
I couldn't believe my ears. Cut my baby in half? No, no! I cried out to King Solomon, don't kill my baby. Give her the child so he might live. I would rather he live with someone else than die.
With those words, I knew she was the real mom, It was clear. We gave her back her son, alive and well. Praise be to God. I love his wisdom in me. It helped me so much today, and it helped this precious mom to have her baby returned to her.
When the people of Israel heard about King Solomon's decision, oh, they respected him very much. They saw God's wisdom in him to make the right decisions, to be a good king. His wisdom was much greater than anyone else. God's wisdom showed him the path to take, to obey God's plan for his life. It helped him to lead the construction of this beautiful temple and allowed him to speak over 3,000 wise teachings that would help the people in their daily life. Kids, people from all over the nations came to listen to King Solomon's wisdom. And even us, we can read his words of wisdom in the Bible, especially, well, in the Old Testament, actually, like the book of Proverbs. Oh, see how much God blessed him with wisdom?
Incredible! God made Solomon a hero of wisdom. I want to be a hero that way too. What about you? I want God to give me that helpful spy intelligence called wisdom, to know what is good, to choose what is right, to honor my God, for wisdom will make me walk in his plans, and his wisdom will also be a blessing to people around me. We need to ask God's wisdom. We just need to ask for it like Solomon did. James 1 verse 5 says, if any of you needs wisdom, you should just ask God for it. God is generous. He enjoys giving to all people. So God will give you wisdom.
Oh, God loves this kind of prayer. We also have God's word, the Bible, that teaches us about wisdom. So reading it, I gain wisdom this way too. So then let's read the Bible often to gain lots of wisdom. Listen to what Proverbs 4, chapter 4, verse 5 and 7 says, get wisdom, for she will protect you. Love wisdom, and she will guard you. Oh, I like that. God's wisdom will protect us from making bad decisions and from harmful situations too.
All of the wisdom I gained by reading God's word, I need to show in my life. I need to put it into practice like Solomon did. I need wisdom in what I say and what I do. Kids, wisdom is thinking before I talk, to say kind words. And when we are angry, it can be hard to do. But, Proverbs 5:1 says, a gentle answer will calm a person's anger, but an unkind answer will cause more anger. And that's a lot of good wisdom right there. So you want to write that down or something. Now in the next verse, Proverbs 16:24 says this, kind words are like honey, sweet to the soul and healthy for the body. And this verse was so good. I mean, who doesn't like honey? It's tasty. James 3:17 says, the wisdom from above is first of all pure. It is also peace-loving and gentle at all times. And it's willing to yield to others. It's full of mercy and the fruit of good deeds. I need lots of wisdom, and you need lots of wisdom every day. So we need to be kind to others to do what is good and pleasing to God.
Wisdom. Never leave home without it. Well, that said, you need wisdom at home too. Live life with God's wisdom. He will prevent you from getting into small and big troubles, and it will guide you into God's plan for your life.
Yep, God's wisdom will keep you out of trouble. I really, really want to share with you one more Bible verse about wisdom. Proverbs 3 verse 5 says,
Do not depend on your own understanding. God's wisdom in this verse clearly warns us to not trust our own understanding of things, our own wisdom, because it can lead us into trouble. So this ball represents me. And kids, I cannot trust my own wisdom. That's right. Then verse 6 says, seek his will in all that you do, and he will show you which path to take. Wow! So this ball represents Jesus. To seek his will is to look for what God wants for me and not what I want. One way is with reading the Bible, like we talked about before. Another way is by praying, by spending time with our Jesus, worshiping him and asking him, Jesus, what would you like me to do today? Kids, we need prayer. We need our eyes on Jesus to seek his will, his plan for us, right? We need our eyes on Jesus. Well, let's play a little game now, okay? So let's practice keeping our eyes on Jesus. So I'm gonna move this ball around, and kids, make sure that you keep your eyes on the ball, okay? Ready? Gonna go a little bit faster. Woo! Did you keep your eyes on the ball? If you did, that's awesome. So we're gonna make it a little bit harder now, okay? So we're gonna keep practicing to keep our eyes on Jesus. So I'm gonna place this little ball under one of these cups, okay? So I'm gonna place it under there. And what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna move these cups around and make sure that you keep your eyes on the cup with the ball, just like we wanna keep our eyes on Jesus. So here goes, ready? Whoa, do you guys know? Did you keep your eyes on it? Well, if you guessed it was this one, you were right. Great job, you kept your eyes on the cup. Well, let's make it a little bit harder yet. Let's add a fourth cup, okay? Here we go. So we're gonna put the ball under this one. So let's see if we can keep our eyes on it. Ready, set, go. All right. So kids, do you know which one it is? Did you keep your eyes on it? Well, if you said it was this one, you were right. Great job. Well, I think that was so much fun, right? So kids, let's keep practicing. Let's spend lots and lots of time with Jesus to learn to walk in his wisdom in everything that we do.
Wasn't that a fun game? Now let's take a time of prayer. I invite you to lift up your hands and to close your eyes. Oh God, you are so amazing, so good, so full of love. I just love how you gave Solomon so much wisdom when he asked. You took pleasure in doing so. I need your wisdom too, Jesus. I want to have my eyes on you. Show me how I can walk in your wisdom and not mine. Guide me. Holy Spirit, remind me to spend time in the Word and in prayer to grow in wisdom. You are the best one to help me. Amen.
Be wise. Choose God's wisdom. See ya.